but took a sliding start because they started rowing earlier, and I guess they were behind the line, and they wanted to do this to take some speed while taking the start. Others were really on the line and were waiting until they heard the sound that released them. Numéro 123, c'est la Ligue Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes, et l'autre c'est le 127, si je lis bien, c'est un bateau italien de Rowing Club Genovese. That has to correct their course. Look at this, they went too much to the left. Now they have to come back. Ooh, and it's very close with the other boats. They lose so much time. The rowers from Ligue Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes, Léo Beaumaine and Léa Gouthière. And also the other boats are stopped there because of this. They're all three far too close together. It is such a pity, and this gives the opportunity to the boat from Ligue Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes, who was not taking the right correction, to do. And you see the two other boats start again here. So it's a stop, a complete stop in the boat now. Even lost an oar. C'est la Ligue Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes qu'on avait vu tout à l'heure. Et là, ils se font passer à la bouée par le 127, par le Rowing Club Genovese. Et, très beau passage de bouée pour les Italiens. Taking gold in the double mixed here at the Challenge Prince Albert II. Well done to them. And look at the face of Mitchell, really, you can see the effort he has been doing. The second, also no need to put a final sprint. And it is a nice race here between the German team and the Czech Republic. Look at this, the two boats are really side by side for the last strokes. Who will take it? I cannot tell you because I'm not in front of the line. It will be up to the umpire, but very nice last stretch there for Michaela Tomaszkikova and Dusan Maciacek from Velerský Plateau.